Hello friends and everyone, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. I am Frederick and in this video I'm going to talk about streaming mode in .NET 8 Blazor. We have four render modes in Blazor, that is for .NET 8, and I've made a video explaining each of them. So if you want to know more about this, please check the description. I'll put the link over there. Please subscribe to this channel so you can receive more information on .NET technology, and also click on the notification icon to receive updates as soon as I upload new video, and give a thumbs up to this video as well if you think it is well with you. Okay, so now we talk about streaming mode. It is an enhancement made to static render mode. Now let's talk about these two guys here, the static render mode and the stream rendering mode. Now with the static render mode, let's say you want to create your e-commerce app. Now in your home page, you want to load the product from the database by calling an API, then you load the product onto the client screen. Now when you use the static mode, it's going to load everything on the server. When the data is ready, then it dumps it onto the screen of a client. So in the course of gathering the data from the server, the client screen is going to be blank. So there's nothing going to be displayed until the product is ready before it gets it from the server and I'll dump it onto the screen of the client for the client to see everything. That is for the static render mode. Now the new feature that is this streaming render mode, what does it do? Instead of making the screen blank whilst fetching the data from the API, what you want to do here is you want to display something like loading. I want to display something like a placeholder. So you can just replace the placeholder when the data is ready. You know how YouTube works. As soon as you decide to tap on YouTube icon or YouTube app and want to visit the app, you will see that you have this placeholder that gets loaded. As soon as the videos are ready, it's removed the placeholder and now dump the videos onto the screen. I have this video or this project set already, and that's what I'm going to use to explain this streaming render mode. Let's run it first and see what we have. So when we check the home page here, that is just a .NET 8 web app project, and here I did not include any render mode. So this is what I did. I went to File, New Project, and I could see this is a web app from .NET 8. So click on that and give it a name, Blazor app 2. And now in here, we see we have this interactivity type. So we see this is a none, and none is a static mode. And rendering mode support or stream render mode support the static mode. That is why we are using this none. Okay. Now click on create and get this app created. Now when this app is created, what's the next thing to do? We just navigate to the home page or any of the components here. I made it as product list. And you can see we have this attribute as stream rendering mode on top. Now check here. That is just a container. And you can see from here, I am just making a loop to a list component here and now displaying the items as you can see from here. Now check this. If you come here, you can see I have a list of products. But first of all, I have to create a product. So this is the product that I created. It's a product class. So we have an ID, name, description, and now image. Aside from creating this product, then what I'm going to do here is I'm going to make a population. I'm going to populate this product. So you can see we have this product over here, container. And when the page initializes, I am calling this method. Now this is a task method as an async task. And now this is what I'm doing. I'll just delay the process doing nothing. I'll just delay it for 5 seconds. Then I'll start making the population. So we say I'm populating this product container. I am adding first item, next item, third item, up to the sixth item. Now you see from here, I have this image names here, and I have this image in the folder, in the www root folder. You can see these are images that I have. Here, we are not making a real call from an API. But as soon as we add this async task delay, it seems like we're making a call, right? So it's going to delay a little bit for 5 seconds. Then it's going to populate this and I'll return. It is the same as making a call from the API, because you know when making a call from the API, it takes time. So this also we're going to delay for 5 seconds, and that'll be enough for this. Okay, so first of all, whilst we have this, we just want to look through this, and that's all that what we are doing. Now you can see that when you check down here, we have something here that's a streaming dot 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 dot, right? Now check this. We are checking that if product is now, this is what you want to do. So if product is not now, then display each product in this product container. But in case this product has no data, then display this. Now you can see from here that as soon as this method is called, it initializes this container and has set it to empty. As soon as it calls this method, it has to delay for 5 seconds. So in such case, by delaying, this product is going to be now. So instead of displaying this, it's going to skip up to this and display this, because at this time, the product will be now. Now we are saying when product is now, we want to display this information. Now here we are making a count, so we are displaying all the sales items. So this sales items, you want to have a placeholder which are 6 to replace each. Okay, so we have this placeholder here, and as you can see, we have this for loop. So we have this I equal to or less than 6. It's going to start from 1 and up to 6. Then the increment is 1, 1, 1. We have this card created, and this card is from SyncFusion. So if you want to know how to use SyncFusion, just have to download, install this package. So when you go to dependencies, packages, and you see I have installed SyncFusion Blazor.notification and also SyncFusion Blazor.teams. So you have to install these two packages. After making the installation, you go to this app.razor and now add the CSS and now the JS script file. So you add these two files to the project over here in the app.razor. Now when you are done, you go back to the product list and you can now include the skeleton shape. But before you do this, you have to include this namespace on top here. You can just put them in the import.razor or maintain them here. Now since we are using this skeleton at only this page, that is why we have it here. Now you have to register this missing component for this app to get aware. So in the program.cs file, you add builder.services.addSyncFusionBlazor, and that is all. Now when you come back here, we are looping through. So we want to display this SyncFusion, the skeleton system, and now you want to get a square. You can see we have rectangle, we have circle. This you want to have a square, and now you want to this effect up here is wave. Here we have pause, we have none, etc. But here we want to set the wave. This is a height, and then that is a width. Okay. So first of all, this page supports stream rendering. Now let's set this page. Let's set it to off and see what I'm talking about. So Control K and C. This is off. Now let's run this application and see what we have when this page is rendering in a static mode. So while this is loading, let me show you one thing. You know that here we are saying if product is null, then you want to display this, right? If the product is null, it means you want to display this. And now when the page initializes, definitely the products are going to be null. So this product here is going to be null. There won't be any product here because you're going to delay this task. But instead of showing this, when you use the static mode, nothing will be displayed because it's going to wait and now make the page ready before it dumps onto the screen of the browser. Now let's have a look here. Now we are in the page, and now in here, if I click on this product, see what happens. It's going to delay for 5 seconds, and then this page is going to be blank. Let's see. So you see it is still stuck. So I click on this, but it is still stuck. It's going to delay for 5 seconds, and as soon as the 5 seconds elapses, you see we have the page, or you have the images were displayed over here. Let's get it again, and it has delayed for 5 seconds again. You can see I click on this 5 seconds, and you can see it is still delaying for 5 seconds, then it gets displayed. All right, although in our page or in our project, we said that if this page is null or if this component is null, display this. But since it is a static mode, it did not. Let's have a look using the render mode. Maybe this will help you understand what I'm talking about. So let's check this product count. So here, let's first make a check by using this product.count. Okay, so if this is greater than 0, that's what you want to do here. Now let's run this. So let's change this web browser to Chrome. Now let's run this and see. All right, so now the page is ready. Now if I click on product, let's see what happens here. So I'm going to click on this. Now you can see we have this streaming, and you can see we have this indicator as a placeholder here. as soon as the page is ready, you could see the placeholders, they are missing, and the content have been dumped onto the screen of the browser. So this is the stream render mode. Now let's have a look. Maybe we made a change, so let's change to static also. And now let's see if we're going to have a display of that. So Control K and C, let's comment this. And now let's run this again. All right, so now let's see, this is a static mode. Now here, there's no render mode or stream rendering supportive. Now if I click on this, you can see that it's still going to wait for 5 seconds, and now this gets loaded. You can see that. So that is it. And now if I change it back to the render mode, let's see again. Okay, so if I click again on the product, like you see, you're going to have this placeholder. And now this is going to display till the product gets ready and it gets dumped onto the screen. All right, so that is a way to use this streaming mode. Now, the question is, when is this useful? It is useful when you want to display a data to a user. So that's when it is useful. Now, you know, when you use this stream render mode, it is not interactive, meaning maybe if I have a button and I click on, I want to add maybe this product to the cart. If I click on this, it is not going to be active unless I create a component and I'll set the page on top of that component as either interactive server or interactive WebAssembly or auto. Then I can make a reference to that component in here. Other than that, if I just add a button here and I add a method, it's not going to work. Let's quickly have a look here, then we end this video. So in here, we go to the page. Now within each button here, we can add a button. So we have this card body. We can add card footer. So let's see. Okay. Now let's have a button here, and let's wire it up to an event. Then we can just make a call of this, point it to add to cart method. Then let's specify this item. Now within this, let's create a method here. So this is private void. Okay, so let's display it down here. Okay, now let's see. So we're gonna say, let's have a mechanism to display it. Now down here, we're gonna say ID. Okay, so you see that here we have, let's terminate this well. Okay, so let's say the item that you're going to click, we want to assign the values and display them down here. Okay, so in here, if I click on this, we're going to say that this ID is equal to this model.id. We have this name is equal to model.name. And we have description is equal to model.description. All right. Now we have this. Let's put a breakpoint. Let's put a breakpoint here. Okay, so let's put it here. And let's run this. So if I click on this add to cart model, this has to get fired, isn't it? So add to cart. Let's make it well. Add to cart. All right, so let's run this again and see. Okay, so we have this. Let's go back to the product. Now it is in a render mode of our streaming render mode. Now within this streaming, let's see. So if I click on add to cart, you will see this button is not interactive. It is not interactive. Although we have it wired to an event, but it is not interactive because it is static. The mode is static here. This is just an enhancement to the static render mode. I know static doesn't make the page interactive, because it just displays everything on the screen of the browser, so there's no connection for communication. But the question is, how can you make this page interactive? How can you make this button interactive? What you can do here is to create a component. So let's do that quick, and I'm going to show you that. Okay, we're not going to go we're going to dive into that. I'm just going to show you just a component here. So let's add a component, and now this component is going to be button. So let's say this is cart button. So within this cart button, this is what we are doing. So when you come back to this page list, let's grab this button in here. Let's cut it, go to this button, and now paste this button here. So within this method, you're going to remove this, and now you're going to create a property as parameter. So this is going to be parameter. And now let's have a property here as product. And maybe you can have product in here. Okay, or cart item. Then you can have this method. So maybe you have this method as a private void. You paste in this. Then instead of having this product list down here, maybe you can just grab this, cut this, come to this cart method, and then down here, let's display it over here. Then we go back to this product list. So here we're going to cut this, and in here, let's have this variable set in here. Now the same product list, when this button is called, this is what you want to do. So you want to just assign the values here to the variable that we have created, and we can do that in here. Okay, so this is what we are doing. Now this shouldn't be an event, so we have to just call it just a method wired up to this, and here we just have to replace this with this card. Save that. You see, so that is what you want to do in here. Let's see. Now when you go to this product list, we can just clear this. Now where we have this cart footer, let's use this cart button. Okay, and now in here we have to provide cart item. So this cart item, set it to this item in here. So let's see. Now if I click on this, and let's run this application and see what we have. Okay, so the app is ready. Click on this product and let's wait for this to get ready. Okay, so if I click on this, see what happened. You can see if I click on this, let's see if this event will get fired. Okay, so it is not. Let's see the reason why. So within this page, we have to make this as interactive. So this card button on top here, let's add an attribute. Then within this attribute, we're going to say interactive server. Let's see, we can just make a copy from what we have in here on top here. Then let's paste it here. So we can just make a change. And I think it is interactive server. Okay. Now we can just put a breakpoint. Then let's refresh this. So let's try that. So you can see that it keeps loading, and that is what we need to do here. So we go back to the settings. Now we have to make this as interactive. So where we have this add razor component, let's also make it dot add interactive server component from here. So dot add. And you see we have this interactive server render mode. Okay, so now we have this. Let's refresh it again. Okay, so product. Now let's see. So we have the page ready. If I click on this add to cart, you see now this event get fired. Click on continue on. And now I'm going to see this name here. You see we have this ID, the name over here, and at the description. If I do the same, you're going to have the method same get fired, and because I have the same over here, I do this, and because I have it, and I can do any, and I'll have it as well. Okay, so that is it. Now you've seen how to use stream rendering, and you've seen how to make a page interactive, and now attach it to the stream rendering page. Thank you so much for watching. If you learned something here, please give me a thumbs up to this video. If you have any issue too, put it at the comment section and I'll attend to you as well. Thank you so much for watching. Take care of yourself, and I'm going to catch you up in the next video.